Monza. It's the home of race cars here this afternoon as it's time for a Sunday edition of the iRacing Formula Renault 2.0 Championship. Expect high-speed racing, drafting, passing, crashes, and oh yeah, that photo finish camera is already warmed up. We'll be starting in just a moment here on the world's greatest sim racing broadcaster, RaceBot TV, streaming live on iRacing Live. Race car! Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Monza for this round of the Formula Renault 2.0 Championship here on RaceBot TV, streaming live on iRacing Live. Will Vincent here. We haven't unfortunately got ourselves Shakespeare here today, but that means you're sat with me for the next, I don't know, 25 minutes or so here. Martin van Luijtenhol then. He sets the early pace in qualifying, as these guys, as ever, will have themselves two laps to go as fast as they can around this track. You can see there's 3 minutes left of qualifying. And, well, Van Luijtenhol thinks his first lap is okay. Well, it may well be, because Govan Keening just goes off there. That's his chance for pole position gone. So, let's have a look at Jan Twitter instead. There we can see Van Luijtenhol currently leads the way in qualifying. Keening in second, Schwitter in third, on board with that Petronas machine for Club Diatch, heading himself down into the parabolical. Let's listen in. P4, Schroeter's lost a position. As we can see that Mark Perez is now up into third place. David Williams in the Kawana Sim Sports machine. He's now working himself a very messy Ascari chicane. He's currently scored, you can see it there, about 0.8 of a second behind your race leader. Now qualifying is important here, but it's not as important as other tracks. And the reason why is because this is an actual draft city. This Monza race track, we all know, we all love it. It's got three chicanes there. You can see there on the top of your screen, that is the oval. Hasn't been run at for years. But there we can see David Williams heading himself towards the start-finish line. What time will he do as he crosses the stripe? He's down into P9. Can he improve? The answer to that question is, oh, I don't think so. David Williams will remain in P9 for the time being. Oh, Pedro Morias there. It's up a place. He's up into P5. He won't have time to do his second lap in that Radical Steel Series Team Hirachi machine. But in the 13 machine, a good qualifying all the same. Up in P5. There's Julian Gorion. There we can see the 7. I love that race car. Look at it. It's the Benetton machine. And it's pretty. It's beautiful. As he now works himself down into the Ascari chicane. We're on board of him then. A minute, 42 seconds to go. He should get this lap in the books. He has done both of his laps, actually. So this is actually a cooldown lap. But all these drivers have now done their qualifying. That will give us the ample opportunity in a moment to have a look. As you can see there, they're looking at the race car as it heads itself down into the Parabolica. And out the Parabolica. And now probably on towards pit road. Indeed, no, it's going to stay out. Doesn't realise that qualifying's over. It's okay. We'll let him go past the stripe again. The magical technology will work and we'll get him to his grid spot before we know it. But there is a look then up above at this magnificent racetrack. Checkered flag is out for qualifying. Let's get ourselves your starting grid for this afternoon's event. Well, Manu van Leeuwenhoek will have it then. Govankini in second. It was close out front. Bigger gaps behind. Number one machine, Mark Perez in third. Jan Sweeter in fourth. Recycle this grid on back. Slatino, 26 drivers here today. So a full complement. We take it on this fantastic Monza racetrack. We'll cycle it on back even further. You see some big, some familiar names. Now, this race, of course, we're not going to have everyone participating. Nick Rowland, a good friend of mine, of course, he's in P15. Because of the fact we've got near endurance going on, if you like your GT cars instead of your open wheel cars, it's okay. Neo hasn't stopped. Visit iRacing.com/live. They'll get you up to date with that race right about now. So it's time almost to head ourselves to the starting grid for this afternoon's event. There you can see track temp, 79 degrees Fahrenheit. We've got some wind here today. It's 44% race relative humidity on this track. It's 5.7 miles in length. It's a 12 lap race here as well. Looking forward to it as these guys now are on the grid. They are just a couple of moments away from getting ready to go racing. There you can see the number two machine, Martin van Leeuwenhoek, will be bringing the field to the green flag at the start of this one. And there you can see most of your field are now happily ascended on your starting grid. Lights are on top of the iRacing.com gantry. Let's get this 12-lap show on the road. This race, it starts now. Task number one, survive turn number one. They're going too wide already. Battle for second position. Down to the inside. Oh, we got big trouble on the rear of the field. We got a car turn around before they even make it to turn number one. And well, that car just went all forms of off. We'll get an update of who that one is in a moment's time. But we said survive turn number one. Most of the drivers survived turn number one itself. One driver didn't actually survive the run in towards turn number one on lap number one. Yeah, There's your field charging itself there. I love this camera angle so much as well. We've got a car turn around. Down the second chicane, we've got a number of drivers turn around. Nick Roland's on pit road. He's out of the event. We've got ourselves three drivers out of this event. Let's get ourselves another look. Here is Marcus Mayer and Nick Roland. They've had themselves an incident. And this is on the run down into the second chicane from what we can tell. Let's keep an eye out then on Marcus Mayer, number 14 machine. We've got Nick Roland in the number 15 machine. There we go. Oh my word, into Curva Grande. What was that? Oh, we got three cars upside down. We had four or five cars out in total. That one demands itself another look. We're going to ride this one on board with Nick Roland. There you can see Roland. Oh, the two cars come together. Nick Roland there goes into the wall and he gets hit three or four times. You need one more look from that one. But I think it all started really with that incident with Nick Roland. And you can see there a bit of beating and banging going on. Number 15 machine on your right hand side of your screen. The two work themselves behind the trees. There we are. We get a better angle. There are three wide through Curva Grande. It didn't work. As a consequence, you have many, many guys now classified as out of this event. But Mark Perez now leads this motor race. He has just got himself ahead. He's behind Martin van Leeuwenhoek. I'm completely wrong. Martin van Leeuwenhoek leads this race. Mark Perez in second. Mark Perez, of course, got himself past Jan Sweeter at the start of this event, and he is now scored in that second position. That ticker will work itself along the top of your screen. If you want to get social with us, oh, you can do so. /RaceSpotTV at RaceSpotTV. There are the deets on your screen. It's behind. We're going to go on board with that driver of Xavier Sanchez right now in that number six Iberia machine as he's trying to hunt down Andrea Perez Sola. This is a scrap for P6. And of course, this is Lesma number one. Lesma number two is coming up shortly. And it's the slowest two corners, really, in a form of technical manner on track. From here on in, as there's a big wiggle from Perez Zola. That will give now Xavier Sanchez the chance to just move himself a little bit closer. We know that this can be a draft track, but there are some crosswinds here today. As we turn our attention back to Mark Perez out front, he is closing. He is hunting Martin van Leeuwenhoek. We're on board of him now. The gap is scored at 0.3 seconds as they head themselves down towards the Parabolica once again. Not going to work there. He's going to have to stay behind for the time being. But behind, we have got ourselves four drivers then classified out the race in the early going. We've got Nick Roland, Clark Williams, Marcus Mayer, and David Zaranzo. Alexandra Valente is coming out of pit road. There you can see him doing that right now. As there is Martin van Leeuwenhoek. There you can see Mark Perez. Perez looking close. Will Perez go down to the inside? In towards? No, he won't. He's going to get off the noisy pedal and he's going to stay in line. But Goenkini there, he's going to go side by side with Johan Gorgon as they come down into that first chicane. Well, you can see there, Goenkini in the number 11 machine will make himself up a position. He's now up into P10 already. He's looking for more. We've seen issues at Curva Grande already here today. And Keeney now, oh, he just touches the rear of Yuri Fire as they come down through Curva Grande. That's not what you want to have happen. This is a momentum track as well, so you want to make sure you get yourself a good run. As Keeney will storm it down to the inside. Will he get the pass done? The answer is yes. Fantastic maneuver into the second chicane. Second look of that one is up for you now. Well, it was a fantastic run then for Keeney. You can see just how late he braked. He actually almost got himself alongside the driver of Javier Sato in toward that second chicane. But well, we've got so much racing still to go here. There is the pass, and of course, as it stands, we've got more battles as Keeney's going to move himself up another place. That's round the outside at Ascari. When do you ever see round the outside at Ascari? Keeney is on fire right now. We have to get ourselves another look at this one because you just don't see it happen. This is down into the Ascari chicane. We're going to get a look in from up above. You can see he's on the outside line. Here's the car next back. He just broke so late into the corner. Keeney round the outside, round the outside, round the outside. He manages to get that pass complete. He's having himself a fantastic race. He's been losing all there. Setting the fastest lap of the day. It's a two-horse race as it stands right now. Running ourselves along board with the driver of Mark Perez. He runs in second, but Perez has himself a 2.2 second advantage as it stands over Jan Sweeter. Behind, side by side, we've got Sanchez versus Sola as these guys work themselves into the first chicane as well. It is going to be there. Sanchez versus Sola. Sola is going to have the advantage of this one, but hey, he's coming keenly once again. This guy is on a mission, make no decision, as he's now on the outside in Curva Grande, as he'll come down in towards the second chicane. He will lose a draft for a moment, because you can see that number six machine is better placed to get the draft, but Keeney will have the inside line, and he'll move himself past. That was nice and easy. That is three drivers in five chicanes there for Gavin Keeney. This is fantastic watching him right now. He has, though, got a 1 second deficit now to Perazzola, so that one will calm itself down for just one moment. Your top eight on lap number 4 of 12, it's Van Lusenor from Perez. Keeney turn around. Oh, he's had such a good race until that point. And oh no, it all went wrong for him in just a blink of an eye down at the first Lesmo. Is this in the second Lesmo? He may have had an incident just there coming off the corner. Yeah, he gets himself onto the gravel, loops that car around, doesn't hit anyone, but well. This is a crazy, fantastic race right now. I apologize for anyone's eardrums. It's been completely obliterated. We've now got João Vaia versus Xavier Sanchez as they come down in towards Parabolica once again. You'll see there they'll work themselves behind the trees. We'll go on board with the driver of João Vaia as they come down in towards turn one. And this time by, it's Perez who sets the fastest lap of the motor race. In towards turn number one. He's going to get himself the pass. That's João Vaia up into P7 right now. Fantastic running by him as he will move himself up a position just for the moment. Hey, watch you there. That's his YouTube handle. We'll put it up on the screen for the next 2 seconds. Behind, you've got yourself Mecca Lamarux right now. He's looking down to the inside. On the outside, actually, in Curva Grande, we have seen this pass work before. If you can get yourself to run out of this corner, you can make yourself the pass. That's Movano just ahead of him. And Mikel Lamarox will have to tuck back into the draft. And this is going to break very late. No, he won't. He will stay where he is for just the moment. So, lots of action going on up and down your field. We have ourselves now five retirees. Valente, Roland, Williams, Soranto, and Mayer. Of course, iRating and points are in effect for this event. These drivers will have four opportunities to set themselves a top point finish. As I do have to say, by the way, I love this number five machine we're seeing on your screen right now of Jürgen Frank. One of the best liveries I've actually seen on this car, kind of replicating the Renault itself. So they have four opportunities. Of course, we broadcast a race for you every Thursday night here on Racebook TV and on Racing Live. This is designed to be more of a world strength field, getting all the drivers from around the world the ability to race. At the same time, pedal to the metal, and of course, this will have a huge impact on some of these guys on championship points. Although, it is worth noting, your number one, number two drivers, they're running in number two and number one right now. As I've got a message there from the number 15 machine. I don't think I can actually repeat it on air. Is Marc Perez then going to move himself to the race lead in towards turn number one? There you can see the ASR car, but no. Mano van Lusenord will get a better run through the first chicane. They will now have to battle it out a bit more. The gap is up to 3.4 seconds, so they can start fighting. They're going to be at halfway distance this time by. Martin van Lusenord leads this motor race. Marc Perez is running in the second place. 0.2 seconds separating these drivers. Doesn't look as though Perez can do anything in towards the second chicane, but behind Pedro Marias versus David Williams, they are close. But again, Marias can't get anything over the Kawana SimSports car as they'll come down in towards chicane number two once again. Now into Lesmo number one. Morris actually dropped back here. The dirty air, the crosswinds does play an impact. And we talked about the fact that there is 10 kilometers an hour wind here today. Air temperature is 79 degrees Fahrenheit, and the track temp, well, that is 90 degrees Fahrenheit. Behind, here's the train, hits the Trulli train, started by Xavier Sanchez. We'll have a look from the rear of him. And so far in today's event, well, Sanchez is up one place. His last lap was his fastest lap, a 149.637. As he's got himself, yeah, Vara right behind him, as well as Xavier Sarto. You want to know where Govankini is, by the way? He's fallen back now down into P15. He's actually had a pretty miserable day. There you can see, he was the guy who was passing everyone at one stage in this event. But not been a good day. He is down 14 places overall. His low has been 14 places overall in this event. So really not the day that number five would have wanted. He got himself a slowdown at the start. You can see he's looking for more already, up into 14th now, as we'll come down into Curva Parabolica. We'll just have a look from the rear now of that number 11 machine. But it's just sometimes at Monza, if you have one incident, it all just carries on bottling up. And who can forget, of course, sometimes to make yourself unforced errors. Mika Häkkinen in 1999, as here will come then, side by side in towards turn number one. It's going to be a drag race. 12 places there for Govankini, that he's now officially down in this event, but they're going to go side by side, they're going to go side by side ahead of him as well, in towards turn number one. And in fact, behind them, they've got themselves a nice little scrap as well. There you can see it is Armin Wiese with Maximilian Schneider right now. We're on board with the Schneider driver, running himself in P number 17, number 16 machine, as he now is working himself in that 17th spot. Here's your biggest moves and shakers though in the event so far. Notice David Williams, he is on a charge in that Kawana Simsports machine. We work ourselves and on board of him. He's up 6 places, the most inside of your top 10 as it stands. Mikel Almarox is your biggest mover in this event. He is up 10 places since the green flag dropped to start this one race here today. So Almarox is still looking for a bit more as well, although he has got a bit of time to gain. Of course, you negotiate traffic here, you end up putting yourself into a situation where you form a pack of cars around you rather than chasing down a pack. Here's that free car pack we were talking about earlier. This is the drivers of Yeo Vara, Xavier Sanchez, Javier Soto, and Julian Gorian. Let's go on board with the driver at the rear of the train. This is that number 24 machine, and at number 7 of 12, going to be scored complete this time by, as let's ride a couple of corners on board with that number 24 car. Bit like Daytona, drivers looking down to the inside, sneaking down to the inside, bit of a lockout though, and this is really going to bring this pack together. It's Gurian going to get himself a bit of a tap there onto the rear of the driver of Yeo Sato, but they're side by side ahead of him. We're on board now with the driver of Yeo Vara. They can see left hand side of your screen, this is the number 6 machine of Xavier Sanchez in towards the second chicane. Who will break the latest? The answer to that question is going to be, looks as though Vara will get it. No, it won't. They'll stay side by side, and Vara is going to be able to make up the position. We'll get that YouTube link up on your screen for another 2 seconds. But behind, you'll see now that Sato will go down to the inside of Sanchez. And this is a fantastic little scrap we've got going on down in your mid-pack. Van Luzenor, for those who are wondering, still lead this motor race. So this is why we're keeping it with this mid-pack battle for the time being. Because your top five, actually, are spread out. They are pretty well spread out. Van Luzenor, 4/10 of a second advantage over Perez. Perez has a 5.5 second advantage over Jan Schwitter. Then David Williams, he is 1.9 seconds behind Schwitter. And then Morias runs himself in fifth, 1.2 back from David Williams as it stands. And this is one pack. This is the other. We're on board with Simon Schultz once again, as he now runs himself in the 17th place. But behind, hello, it is Mikel Almarox. But Almarox has lost himself some positions now, as Perez sets the fastest lap in his motor race. He's going to go down to the inside in towards turn number one. We'll turn our attention to that one. So Perez now on the inside. Perez will take away the lead of this motor race. It's taken him a while, but he does now lead. We're going to ride it on board then with Martin Van Luzenord. You can see the effect of that Monza draft in towards turn number one. Wham bam, thank you very much. As Van Luzenord will have to give up the race lead. Now, of course, if he can hold it, they're not going to hold it. We have to stick with this replay, because Van Luzenord has just moved himself back to the race lead. So we're going to keep it with this one, and we'll show you what happened in real time as they headed themselves down into the second chicane here. They're working themselves behind the trees, and now we'll get ourselves a good look as they come down into the second chicane underneath the bridge. And well, that is Perez saying, hey, I can play you a game. But as a loser or now will lead this motor race one more time here. And the gap is 0.2 seconds. They'll come down in towards the Variante Ascari. But you can see that Perez thinks about moving down to the inside. Not going to happen. He'll have to stay in line for the time being. Behind, look at this one. Soto versus Grumman. This is very close there. Between the car, it looks like an Arrows from 2002. And that classic Benetton livery from the late 1980s as well. They're almost going to be too wide, too deep for a moment, but they think better of it. Here comes Perez once again. He should have himself a good run into Curva Parabolica. That's right, a long board of him in the battle for the race lead. Van Luzenor pushes up high. There's going to be 3 laps to go as they cross the start finish line. Let's go on board with Marc Perez then. He's going to look himself a fantastic run. This is really setting himself up for who is going to be the leader at the line. Van Luzenor did lead lap. It's worth noting the finish line is before the start line at this event. And Marc Perez does, though, go back to the race lead. But the next question is going to be a big one. Where do you want to be? Where do you want to be in this event? Do you want to be on the final lap leading, or do you want to be in second place? You want to be leading after the second chicane, or do you want to be leading on the run out of Ascari? There are so many storylines still to go in the next 2 3/4 laps of this event. And on board is Sato once again. He's got himself now, Yuri Gurriel, right behind him as he'll come down in towards the second chicane. Look at that YouTube plate. I think you should go and check it out as I come down in towards that second chicane now. By the way, no, we've not been paid for that. And it does look as though that Gurriel will stay where he is just for the time being. The four drivers still nose to tail. Behind, you've got Mikel Amarux and Simon Schultz. They are still close. And there's going to be a spin there. There's going to be a guy in the wall. That is going to be the driver. Oh, Simon Schultz there. We'll get him up on your screen. There you can see him. Simon Schultz has had himself an incident. We'll get ourselves another look at this one then. In towards the second chicane as well. We've not had many unforced driver errors, but we've had one or two. Down into the second chicane, super slow-mo camera. You can see just high there, over that curb, unsettling in the car, goes to attack the next corner, catches the sausage curb, two wheels up in the air, and from then on in, Simon Schultz was always going to be on a run to try and find some grip. He couldn't. That car had to do some donuts, spin it around. It's Marc Perez. Let's go back to the battle for the race lead. Will Perez lead this motor race at the line? No, he doesn't. The Perez that, even though he's ahead now, coming towards turn number one, he needs a time to move earlier. Because as it stands, Marc Perez is not leading when it's most important, when they cross the start-finish line. So he's going to now spend the next lap and a half testing that one out. We're on board with Perez as it stands. He's going to work himself in towards the slipstream. Once again, will he poke high out of Curva Grande? Oh, yes, he will. There's one in Van Luzenhorde alongside of him. Perez will have the inside line in towards the second chicane. And it looks as though that Perez will indeed take that race lead away. But the next important question is, can Perez now keep that momentum? We're going to get the white flag this time by, so this is where we expect things to start getting really, really crazy. You see that, ladies and gentlemen, that's called a deep breath. That's a deep breath before you know that something incredible is going to happen. By the way, down in your pack, there is that four-way battle. It is still going on. We'll give you an update about this one once this race is scored complete, because Perez and Van Luzenhorde then. Here we go. A lap and a bit to go. For Ascari, it's Perez, who's not officially led a lap of this event. Then Van Luzenhorde. Van Luzenhorde in second, hunting down Perez for the race lead. Just over one lap to go then. It is Perez versus Luzenhorde into Curva Parabolica for the penultimate time. We're going to go on board with Martin van Luzenhorde in that number two Club Benelux machine. Out of the Parabolica he will come. Will he make the move now, or will he wait? It looks as though van Luzenhorde's got himself a good run side by side, but Perez does now officially lead a lap in this motor race. And that Dark Ortenigo car is going to have the lead, but he's going to lose it in towards turn number one. It's going to be Van Luzenhorde on the outside, and he looks as though he will be able to sweep by and get himself the race lead for just a moment. Now it comes down to what can Perez do? Can Perez respond as they work themselves through Curva Grande? No, not just yet. But behind, we've got ourselves a fantastic battle going on with these guys. Look at them, they're too wide into the chicane. That is Adrian Palazzolo and Sanchez, as Perez is going to go back to the race lead. They're going to go side by side. Second chicane, Perez not able to do anything there. He got close, but not close enough. Back on board of him, into Lesmo number one. He's dancing to the right, dancing to the left. Can he do anything? As they stay by side again behind him, we got so much going on here. As we can see, in towards Lesmo number two, as behind, we'll talk about that one after the race, but Sanchez is holding off Soto for the moment, and Keeney involved in battles, and Keeney there turned around in the second chicane. Look at that one, he's going off-roading in the final lap of this motor race. But here is Van Leeuwenhoek, one more lap to go, half a lap to go, a third of a lap to go from the rear of Van Leeuwenhoek, as he heads himself now down out of Ascari in towards Parabolica for the final time. Who would it be? Would it be Van Leeuwenhoek or will it be Perez? One of these drivers will come home with victory, and they're going to go side by side in towards Curra Parabolica for the final time. Van Leeuwenhoek, turn that camera around. There you can see, well, Perez, he will try and take the inside line. Set your photo finish cameras up, because here we go towards the start finish line. It's Van Leeuwenhoek scrapping it out with Mark Perez, and at the line, it's going to be Perez who claims victory here today. Mark Perez will win out in this event. What a crazy finish. Replay coming up for you now from Mark Perez. And here we are then, through the Parabolica, working themselves down towards the start finish line. We'll slow it down. It was close. It was very, very close. If you want to know how close it was, 1/1000th of a second close. That is how close it was here today, and what a run these guys have had. Perez wins out for Martin Van Leeuwenhoek. We need to get ourselves one more look from on board with Mark Perez and show you this one. As you can see, he's going to now have Van Leeuwenhoek go down to his inside, but he just spots the gap there. It was fantastic driving as Van Leeuwenhoek getting himself a bit loose onto the rumble strip, and then we'll show you this in real time. Van Leeuwenhoek, you can see Perez crosses the line just ahead. Perez will win out here today. And there is official confirmation. 1/1000th of a second, Mark Perez wins out in the Formula Renault 2.0, just like the old days at Monza. Fantastic. Jan Suíta coming home third. David Williams in fourth. Pedro Moyas in fifth. Andrea Perez-Sola in sixth. Xavier Sanchez, Xavier Soto, Goyen and Mikel Lamarock, so you round out your top 10. Oh my word, what a day we've had here today. I want to show you a couple more replays of what happened between those couple of guys at the end of this motor race, because it was just that exceptional. But first, here's the remainder of your results. As you can see, the top 20 drivers. Now, it's worth noting that of the people who started this event and finished the event, they finished on the lead lap. Alexandre Valente there, of course, 10 laps down. We had ourselves incidents with Clark Williams, Nick Rowland at the start of this event. Also, David Serrano and Marcus Mayer. And that is why they're classified as such. They didn't complete a lap in today's motor race. But here is another look then at what was a fantastic, fantastic finish to this event here this afternoon. We're going to have a look high above as they come down behind the trees, hopefully. There we are, in towards Ascari. And at this point, of course, Van Leeuwenhoek was ahead. We're going to go on board with Mark Perez. We just want you to experience this, ladies and gentlemen. Perez wins out. We'll get ourselves one more look there. We'll zoom it out a little bit more for you as they work themselves down to Curva Parabolica. But wow, what a finish. What a finish here we've had at Monza. And this is why people love Formula Renault 2.0 so much here. They love it because of the quality of the racing. If you want to know how close the finish can get in Formula Renault 2.0, this is all you need to see. Look at these two guys. They are literally centimetres apart in terms of distance as they cross the start-finish line. Marc Pérez wins out. If that was actually the finish line further down the road where the start line would be, it actually would have been Van Leeuwenhoorn who won this motor race. But Pérez wins out. And hey, he's going to be feeling pretty good of himself after that one. Fantastic stuff here at Monza. And that is all we've got time for now. But don't forget, we've got more coming your way here tonight. Of course, we're going to show ourselves some Skippy action later on. It is the Skip Barber 2K World Cup. It'll be here on Racesport TV as ever, streaming live on iRacing Live. I've been Will Vincent. I shall talk to you all soon. Thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye.